In a previous chapter, I mentioned I had spent an entire day fooling around with Face App and then proceed to feel guilty for not doing anything productive, and how I decided to mix fooling around in Face App with learning 3D and fighting cancel culture by creating a series of illustrations that 1. Require Blender, 2. Require Face App, and 3. Promote remarkable people I admire. While I also made that joke level play words using words to describe fruits and animals. Well, this is the third delivery of the Girls with Fruit Animals series, and this time I kinda went full patriotic with this, so this time the mix involves two Mexican individuals who I find remarkable. Sorry guys, it was just too straightforward. You know, watermelons, the color of a watermelon, I mean, it was just there. So I kinda just took the path of less resistance, just kinda like the lions in this example, and kinda like lions in general, I guess. That piece of stand-up comedy is spot on, I mean, and well, in this particular case, I'm kinda like the man who is the lion, who is a lazy one, but at the same time is being productive. Talking about the stand-up comedy, the first gentleman that composes this mix is Franco Escamilla, one of the most, if not the most iconic comedian in current Mexican culture.
Y Grillo es un güey que tú lo ves y dices, este güey se ve que está toda madre y es un hijo de su puta madre, o sea, es un... Sí. Porque cuando lo contratamos, yo lo entrevisté, le dije a mi repre, quiero ser yo el que lo escoge, porque es la persona en la que le voy a confiar la vida de mis hijos, o de tu servidor, o de mis amigos. Entonces lo entrevisto, le digo, ¿cómo te llamas? Y con su acento del DF, ¿no? Dijo, pues dígame, Grillo. Dije, sí, pero no mames, ¿cómo te llamas? Dígame, Grillo. Ok, señor Grillo. Le pregunté, ¿has estado en prisión? Sí. Ok, pero ¿te inculparon? ¿Fue algo que no hiciste? Dijo, nah. Y todavía se reía, nah, sí me la gané. Dije, ok, bueno, es una persona que ya sirvió su tiempo, ya pagó su deuda con la sociedad. Dije, perfecto. Mi querido Grillo, ¿tienes tatuajes? Dijo, ¿eso qué tiene que ver? Dije, el chile no sé, pero todas las empresas lo preguntan. Y no quise ser el único pendejo que no pregunta eso, ¿no? Dijo, no, no tengo, ok. ¿Sabes manejar armas? ¿Cuáles? Todas. Algunas las fabrico. Y dije, chinga, ¿cómo? ¿Tiene usted un jabón, una liga y un segurito? Y, ¡ay, hijo de su puta madre! ¡De pinche MacGyver del mal, güey, ¿no? Le pregunté, ¿consumes drogas? Dijo, no, nunca. Ok. Pero sí podrías conseguirla. Y le pregunté lo que le quería preguntar desde el principio. Me puse muy serio, le dije, Grillo, ¿has matado a alguien? Me dijo, no sé. Y no venían las casillas, ¿no? Como opción de respuesta. Dije, ¿cómo chingados no sabes? ¿No? Y esto es neta, me dijo con una cara tan linda, me dijo, pues no es como que me regresé a preguntarle, ¿estás bien, carnal? ¿No? Y lo contratamos. Yo no puedo hablar de discapacitados porque me veo mal, ¿vale? No puedo hablar de gente de otro color porque me veo racista. No puedo hablar de mujeres porque me veo misógino o machista, no puedo hablar de homosexuales porque me veo homofóbico, pero cualquiera puede decirle lo que sea a un gordo y no pasa nada. No hay una ley que nos proteja. Y gente delgada, de corazón, chinguen a su madre, les voy a decir por qué. Les voy a explicar por qué, ¿ok? Lo voy a explicar. Eres delgado, qué envidia, te felicito. Pero abstente, por favor, de usar esta frase que como caga. ¿Cómo caga que una persona delgada te diga, es que como un chingo y no engordo? Y así como que, mira. ¿Qué te parecería, güey, estar batallando para llegar a fin de mes con los pagos y que llegue Bill Gates y te diga, güey, por más que me gaste el dinero, no se me acaba?
I put his routines in the background while I'm painting, and I gotta say that they make my day like 20% happier. The second element in my Latina beauty blend is not other than Eduardo Salles, also known as Salesino or Salles Graham on Instagram. He is the director of Pictoline and former runner of Cinismo Ilustrado. I can't describe how much I love this guy's brain. I mean, his ideas are so, so brilliant. Actually, some of the pieces that I have done in the past have been covers of ideas of his. And of course, I give him credit every time. And every time that he releases a book, I am the first one in line to go and buy it. And whenever I can catch up with him in a book fair or any place where I am able to attend, I am there because I like to have my books signed by him. He has a very clever book currently sold on Amazon that is called Descripción Gráfica, which of course I have it signed. You can see the seal of approval. Everything is gonna be okay. Everything is gonna be okay. It is fantastic, and you actually don't need to speak Spanish in order to understand it, because it's very, very, very graphic. Well, not in the bad sense. I mean, it's graphic-based is what I meant. So, yeah, it is really clever. And one of the beautiful things about this book is that it is thought to use each one of the illustrations as a postcard, so you can rip them out and give it to your friends, your family, the stranger, whoever needs the message, basically. So yes, it's really nice, and no one is paying me for this. I just love it. I'm not receiving a dime. I mean, the guy doesn't even know that this review exists. I just like to promote the type of content that I consider is worthwhile, and I want to see more of it. And that's basically the principle behind it. Just promote what you love. That's it. So, yeah, I took their hands and faces, mixed them in FaceApp, changed the gender, put the result of a 3D model, sculpted some fancy lines, had a lot of fun with the hair system from Blender, rendered it out, built it to Photoshop to make it better, and this was the result. So yeah, before this video ends, I want to quickly mention a series of podcasters that have great content in Spanish. If you are learning the language and you would like to expand a little bit more on very interesting topics or funny ones or a blend of both, I heavily recommend these four channels in here. And if you already know Spanish, el contenido está muy chingón. Neta bello. So yeah, this is it for today. Hope you enjoy it and have a wonderful day. Bye. In a previous chapter, I mentioned I have spent an entire day fooling around with FaceApp and then proceeded to feel guilty for not doing anything productive, and how I decided to mix fooling around in FaceApp with learning 3D, fighting cancel culture. With learning 3D and fighting cancel culture by creating a series of illustrations that one, require Blender, two, require FaceApp, and three, promote remarkable people I admire. The same part every time. Oh my god. It's not the first paragraph, and I already have more bloopers than content. We are going to stay here the whole afternoon, aren't we? The edit time that I'm going to spend in this is going to be fantastic.